Hello, this is John Schaap and welcome to this video in the updated 2021 version of AOS 8 video series. In this video, we are going to have a look at how to configure a Wi-Fi guest network using an external captive portal running on ClearPass and also using MAC caching so that guest users do not need to re-authenticate every time they connect to the guest network. So the network is the same as in all the other videos. One extra thing that we will have now is VLAN 212, that's the guest VLAN, so every guest user will be in VLAN 212. Because the fact that the captive portal runs on the mobility controller, so that's VMC 1, 2 and 3, you also need to set an IP address on that VLAN on every controller. So I do .1 on VMC 1, .2 and .3. On VMC 3. The IP addressing is done from the DHCP server that you see here on the right hand side. So it's a layer 2 type network, the guest network, with the exception that normally on a layer 2 network you do not have an IP address on the controllers, but because Captive Portal is layer 3 protocol, you do need an IP address on the VLAN on the controller to redirect the captive portal to. So let's go ahead and configure the wireless LAN first. The first thing we need to do is add the VLAN for this guest network, and that's VLAN 212. So I do that at HPE level so that it flows down through the hierarchy to all the individual controllers. Then you go to the individual controller, click the VLAN again, click on IPv4 and set the static IP address there. In this case, that's 10.10.212.1 for the first one with the netmask. And I also set ClearPass as the DHCP relay server. That is not for DHCP because that is done by the DHCP server. But this is purely done for device profiling so that ClearPass can profile the devices that connect to the network so that you know which devices are connecting to the network. So this is the second controller, so that one gets address number 2. And the same thing with DHCP relay here for device profiling. And then we go to number 3, exactly the same thing here. Click on IPv4, and then it's 10.10.212.3 with the subnet mask. And again, the same thing with the DHCP relay. And after that's done, you click pending changes, deploy changes, and then one more time verify by clicking it that it has an IP address and it has the correct IP address, the same thing here, and the same thing for number 1. And that all looks good. Next thing is the wireless LAN itself, so click on plus, give it the name, in this case it's guest 89, the type is guest, and then the VLAN is the guest VLAN that we configured previously. It's ClearPass or external captive portal, and we add the existing ClearPass server that was already done in the previous video. So what you need to do here is configure the host, so ClearPass server, by DNS name. So that's clearpass.arubalab.net. And then the page where you host your captive portal. We'll see that later on the ClearPass site that we use this .php page for hosting the captive portal. And when that is done, then you click pending changes again and deploy changes, and your wireless LAN is configured. Then we need to modify something, so we go to authentication AAA profiles and you will find a guest 89 AAA profile there. What we have to do, because we also want to have MAC authentication, so we have to enable that here, and here we have to set the ClearPass server as the MAC authentication server group. If you also want RADIUS accounting, you can use the same server group like it's shown here. and also at your RFC 3576 server. That I configured already in the previous video, so I just need to add it here. And then deploy the changes again. Next is certificates. If you do not add your certificates to both to ClearPass and to the controllers, you will have warnings on your clients that they don't trust the website that they connect to. So add your captive portal certificate here. So that's what I'm doing here. Select the right certificate. And the certificate comes with a passphrase because it also contains the private key. So you have to type in your passphrase. And then set the certificate format to PFX because that's what I'm using. And set the right usage, so server certificate. Again, this is done at HPE level, so it flows down to all the devices below. When you click the certificate, you see the issue 2 name, and that's very important. You need that later on in your ClearPass configuration. Click pending changes and deploy changes again. And the certificate will now be installed on all the different controllers. So now you need to tell the controllers to use that certificate for captive portal. So you go to web server configuration. That's where you will find the captive portal certificate by default on default. Just select the certificate that we just uploaded and you're done. Go to the controller itself, certificates, and check that the certificate is there on all three. It's the same certificate on all three controllers. If you go to the command line interface and do show web minus server profile, you also see that the captive portal certificate is the certificate that we just installed. So now it's time to configure the ClearPass server. And first thing we're going to do is add a CA certificate to the trust list. That one has been used to issue our certificates either on the controller or on ClearPass itself. So I'm going to add this one here. I select others as usage. And this will add the certificate called SecTiGo RSA Domain Validation Secure Server CA. And there's another one that is already installed, but it's disabled. It's the user trust. So just enable it. And close. And we're done with the CA certificates. So the next thing we need to do is add a server certificate. There's two server certificates for HTTPS, an ECC and an RSA. I will disable the ECC because I don't have an ECC certificate. So otherwise, the browser could ask for ECC and negotiate it and then use this self-signed certificate. So that's not what I want, so that's why I disable it. And I just import the RSA server certificate. So it's an RSA server certificate. I have it in PFX format. Then you search for your PFX file. And the same as on the controller, you need the passphrase to import this certificate because it also contains the secret key. And here you see clearpass.arubalet.net. That's the name that it was issued to. It was issued by SecTiGo. And SecTiGo is an intermediate issued by User Trust RSA. So that is done. If you then reopen a new session with your browser, you can see that it's now using HTTPS, so you could see the certificate chain there. So you see User Trust, SecTiGo, and then the ClearPass certificate, the server certificate. So that's fine. And now we're going to add the guest authentication with MAC caching. So give it a prefix so that you can see what services have been added. The guest SSID needs to match on the controller, so it's guest 89. We don't need to add the wireless controller because it was already done in the previous video. You don't need MAC caching settings. You don't need posture settings. The only thing here is access restrictions. That's very important. The role that was configured by your wireless LAN on the controllers needs to be added here. So guest 89 minus guest minus logon. And you can set a maximum number of devices allowed per guest user. I set it to 3. And the guest access is the role where the guest will be in after successful authentication. You see that it added enforcement, profiles, policies, two role mapping policies, and added 2 services. One is called Mac Authentication and the other one is called User Authentication with Mac Caching. So now we go to ClearPass Guest, and that's where you will find your self-registration portal. I'm going to use the default built-in portal, just enable it. And after it has been enabled, you click Edit and go to Advanced Editor. And that's where you will see back the name, but also the registration page that you filled in your controller. So guest underscore register. You can set a skin here if you want that. For the rest, everything. You can modify a lot of things, but you can leave everything default. But this is very important here. So it has to be set for Aruba, of course. And you have to change qlogin to rubanetworks.com to the certificate that you installed on the controller. That was networklogin.arubalab.net. And that's it. Nothing else needs to be changed here. And then you click Save Changes. So that created your self-service portal. Time now to connect the clients. So here you see an iPhone and it's going to connect to guest 89 by selecting it. And after you connect it, it will automatically pop up the web page on ClearPass where you can create your account if you don't have that yet. So here I'm going to create an account. It's based on an email address and a name. And again, this page can completely be customized the way you want it to be. There's many videos on this channel that show you how to do that. So account has been created and you can now directly click the button. It's in Dutch, but it's called registration. And that automatically authenticates you on the network. And we're done now. We're connected on the guest network and are authenticated. And you can see that back in the access tracker on ClearPass. You see here the username coming in. So it was using the service guest authentication with Mac caching. So it also added the user to the endpoint database with the caching. So it has here the Mac auth expiry time. That's one day from now. So what you will see in a minute is that I disconnect the phone from the network again. And then I connect it back in. First, we're going to have a look at the client itself, how it was added to the endpoint database. You see the Mac auth expiry timer, the username and the role ID. Let's go to the CLI and do a show user table. And you see that john@hpe.com has the role guest and it has been authenticated via web. So that's a captive portal. You will see the difference once the user comes back in after this connection with Mac caching. So first go to the access tracker and see what is happening with Mac caching if the user comes back in. And you will see another entry then here and it uses a different service, the other one, guest Mac caching. So the first one was the captive portal, the second one is the guest Mac caching. And you will see now in the user table that the username, of course, is the same, the role is the same, but the authentication method is different. It's now Mac. So this is using Mac caching to authenticate the wireless user. That brings us to the end of this video. So let's recap what we have done. We've created an open SSID on the controller cluster called guest 89. And when a guest user connects for the first time, it will see a self-service page hosted on ClearPass, where a guest account can be registered by the guest user itself, and then authenticate with the credentials provided. The new guest user is added to the endpoint database in ClearPass, with a Mac caching end time of 24 hours after creation of the account, so that the guest user can leave and rejoin the network without the need to re-authenticate every time. And the mechanism for that is Mac caching. Having public certificates both on controllers and ClearPass is key for a smooth operation without all kinds of warnings on the guest devices. Also, DHCP, DNS and NTP are extremely important for this to work, so make sure you have that configured correctly. Please like, subscribe and let me know in the comments what you think. Bye for now.